everyone. So in today's video, we're going to talk about how to control your blood sugar numbers when you have gestational diabetes. I had a mama who asked me this question, how to control her morning numbers. She's struggling with her morning numbers, so she really wanted some help. So I wanted to do this video for her. I remember at the end of my pregnancy, my numbers were getting really hard to control, especially the morning ones. Now, I've heard for some people, at the end of the pregnancy, their numbers get easier. They could eat pizza, they could eat tacos, and it would be fine. But for me, I couldn't eat any of that. My number would spike when I ate pizza. I remember I had a slice of pizza, and then the second slice, I just ate the cheese and toppings. And I figured maybe that would be good enough because, you know, I ate a lot of cheese, a lot of proteins, and then just one piece of pizza with the actual bread. And my numbers spiked. So it doesn't work for everyone. And then I was having really hard time controlling my numbers at the end of the pregnancy. I Googled a lot. I searched on the mama groups a lot on how to control my numbers. So this is what worked for me. Now, what worked for me might not work for you. So it's really trial and error. You just have to try every food and then see which food works for you. So out of the four numbers that we have to test, the fasting is the hardest to control. The reason being that you cannot do anything to control it besides the midnight snack. For other meals, you can drink water, you can eat less carb. For fasting, it really depends on how your body drops sugar at the middle of the night and then spike later on. It's not something that we can control. The only thing that we can do is eat a really good midnight snack. Now, this is what the Kaiser dietitian told me. You have to eat the midnight snack 30 minutes within that window before you fall asleep. So if you had eaten your midnight snack and then you haven't fallen asleep by, I don't know, after an hour, then you would have to retake your midnight snack. Because that's the only thing that keeps your blood sugar up and not dropping it and then spiking it later on. Now, one other thing that worked for me was a really good night rest. I remember there was a while that I couldn't sleep well and my blood sugar wasn't very good. And then there was a while that my house was under construction because it was raining a lot and my roof started to leak. So I had construction going on for that week and my numbers were horrible because I was stressed, I wasn't sleeping enough. But as soon as the construction was done and I was able to sleep well, my numbers dropped. So it really, really depends on a lot of things, not just the food. Also depends on your surroundings, your stress levels, how well you sleep at night. So make sure you get a full night's sleep. For me, it's usually between 8 to 10 hours, you know. You'll know when you wake up. If you're still tired most of the time, the blood sugar numbers aren't really good. But when I'm fully rested, my numbers are usually pretty good. Now, at the end of the pregnancy, it was really hard for me to control. So I end up having to take metformins, which is a medicine that a pregnant woman take to control their blood sugar. I end up having to take one or two at night. So my morning number, my fasting number is within the control number that it's under 95. That's the recommended number. The fasting number needs to be under 95. And then even with the metformin, if I did not eat a good midnight snack, if I didn't sleep well, my number would still spike. So even if you were taking that medicine, I would still recommend you watch out for the midnight snack, watch out for the hours you sleep, and watch out for your stress level. And then, you know, you could try different food. I know this is crazy, but I've tried cheesecake, and those worked for me. Now, Cheesecake Factory actually have a cheesecake that's sugar-free. So those has, the carb that you need, and then also you would eat some protein with it. Make sure you know the amount. Like, I don't remember. I think I ate like half a piece. Sometimes I get greedy, I would eat the whole piece and I would try to uptake my protein also. I remember Kaiser recommending like a toast with peanut butter as midnight snack. That did work for me in the beginning, but it didn't work for me at the end. So I had to change my midnight snack later on. I remember eating beef jerky. Beef jerky worked for me. You could eat beef jerky and then you could eat a toast. You could eat beef jerky and then you could eat Greek yogurt. Now, remember to choose the sugar-free yogurt. You cannot choose the regular yogurt. Those have too much sugar in it. Look at the label. The label, they always tell you how much carb and how much protein it has. So make sure you eat a sugar-free Greek yogurt. Those have more protein than regular yogurt. Sometimes I would eat cracker with peanut butter. Those worked for me. So just, just try different food and see what works for you and then stick with that. I know at the end it's getting really hard to control, but hang in there, Your baby's coming out soon and then you can eat whatever you want. Right, so with the morning number, let's talk about after the fasting, there's breakfast. Now, fasting was the hardest control, and the breakfast was the second hardest to control because your sugar is already spiked. So as soon as you eat your breakfast, your sugar spikes even more. In the beginning of the pregnancy, I could eat toast, eggs. I could eat practically a lot of things, and my number will be okay. But no milk, because milk is a carb. You cannot have milk when you wake up in the morning. It will spike you. So I didn't have milk. I had like a chicken patty, and then an egg, and then maybe a salad at the end of the pregnancy. And in the beginning, I could have toast, but not at the end. At the end, I was eating mostly veggie and protein. I couldn't really have carbs in the morning because it would spike me. If you really want carbs in the morning, then you would have to drink a lot of water afterwards and then also take a walk. A 20-minute to a 30-minute walk would actually decrease your blood sugar. So if you really, really need to have carbs, just take a walk, drink lots of water, or I don't know, do chores at home, mop the floor, whatever that keeps you moving. Those help decrease your sugar. What else did I eat breakfast? A lot of times I would eat, I know I eat like the craziest thing because I crave a lot of food in the morning because you're hungry. So I would eat a lot of meat, chicken patties. I have buffalo wings. And it worked really good for me. Now, lunch and dinner are actually easier to control because your blood sugar is actually dropping and they're easier to control. And remember, in order for your blood sugar to be consistent in a recommended number, remember to eat snacks every 2 hours. So you will wake up, you will eat breakfast, and then 2 hours later, you will eat a snack, which is like one protein and one carb. And then 2 hours, 2 to 3 hours later, you will eat your lunch. So your body needs that consistency to keep that blood sugar from spiking or dropping. Because once you drop and you eat, it will spike. So just remember to keep eating every 2 to 3 hours. I know it's really annoying, but just keep doing it. So, snacks could be like cheese stick, beef jerky, an apple with peanut butter. It could be a toast with an egg. It's just anything that you can imagine, but one protein and one carb is really important. And then, so for lunch, I usually would be able to eat carbs, but I would still try to control it to a healthy carb. It could be a whole wheat toast, and then with like a salad, with chicken or with beef, and then I could have like a whole wheat tortilla with like chicken or beef, and then just like a taco, a regular taco. So anything that's healthy, it's good for you. And then, what else was there? For dinner, dinner is my happiest time because dinner numbers are the easiest to control. So I usually save my cravings for dinner time. So for dinner, I could eat like a steak, and then I could eat broccolis, and then sometimes I would eat brown rice, sometimes I would eat fries. Crazy, huh? Not the restaurant fries. The restaurant fries has higher carbs. The fries that you bake at home, those are really good. And then eat like sweet potatoes, or what else is there? Like actual, the carbs that you cook. When you go out to restaurants, it's a little bit risky because they have sauces with starch in it. They have sugar in their different seasonings. So those are actually very dangerous because you would eat out and you would eat a steak and maybe you would eat Chinese food with like broccoli and beef, and then your numbers would spike and you have no idea why. And it's because it's the starch and the sauce and the sugar and the seasoning. You just have to watch out. When dining out, it's really dangerous. So I try to eat at home most of the time. I would bake the fries. I would, bake my sweet potato. I would bake my potato. Anything that you bake at home, it's just easier to control the numbers. So I remember my dinner time was my happiest time. I would eat fries, but I always eat meat first. I don't know why. If I eat carb first, my sugar spike. But if I eat meat first, and then veggies, and then I would eat my fries or rice or potato or sweet potato, and then my numbers would be fine. So I guess it's also because I'm pretty stuffed up by the meat and veggies, so by the time I get to the carbs, I can't eat much carbs because I'm pretty full by then. But it really satisfies my cravings that I could eat those carbs at the end of the day. And then if I went a little bit crazy on the carbs that day, I would make sure to ask my husband to take a walk with me after dinner. And I usually do a 20 to 30 minute walk. Those will work. Those help my blood sugar to be dropped by the time I have to test my blood sugar. And that's like after like an hour after you start eating. And then I remember if you really crave restaurant food, go to Costco and buy their buffalo wings. Oh my God, those are so good. Those satisfy my restaurant cravings. And the buffalo sauce one, those are the best because there's no carb in it. And then you can have it with ranch. Ranch is a low carb sauce. So you can have salad with ranch. You can have buffalo wings with ranch. You can have fries with ranch. Ranch was my life back then. whatever you eat, you just remember that if you cannot control your numbers with those food, then just keep trying. Find a food that works for you. And then remember to take a walk 20 to 30 minutes, drink lots of water. Though then it does help. I know the fasting is really the hardest. You just have to keep on trying. I remember I made a slide of the food that I ate as snacks, breakfast in the morning. I'll put the video link down below in the description box so you can go back and see the slides of what I ate. I took a lot of pictures. And then it was also a video of sharing my experience on my whole journey of gestational diabetes. So if you're interested in seeing what I ate when I was pregnant and had gestational diabetes, don't forget to click the link down below. And then I hope that will help you control your blood sugar numbers. If you have any questions, just comment down below. I'll try my best to help you. I hope I covered everything on how to control the blood sugar with each meal. But if not, just let me know in the comment box down below. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to click on thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe.